Sisters and brothers, grace and peace be with you in the crucified and risen Christ. Greetings during this fourth week in Lent. As you know, we've been focusing on the five marks of mission for a number of months now. I want to rehearse those words: tell, teach, tend, transform, and treasure. During the past month of March, we've had two Mark of Mission 1 events that I'd like to highlight. On Thursday, the 16th of March, four of our faith communities, St. Timothy's Griffith, St. Christopher's Crown Point, St. Andrew's by the Lake, Michigan City, and St. Michael and All Angels, South Bend, gathered with 31 other congregations in Indiana to learn about how to develop skills to become a flourishing congregation. There were breakout sessions in financial practices, innovation, the practice of inclusion, appreciative inquiry, and leading deep change. On Saturday, the 25th of March, people from St. John's Bristol, St. John's Elkhart, Grace Fort Wayne, and St. Albans Fort Wayne gathered to learn about an initiative that is called Invite, Welcome, Connect, which our sisters and brothers at St. Albans have committed to for the coming 3 years. I want to thank everyone who took the time to participate in these important Mark of Mission 1 events, seeking to proclaim the good news of God's kingdom in our particular context. I'm especially grateful for Mother Michelle Walker and Father Dan Layton for encouraging and coordinating these events, and a special shout out to Father Miles Brandon of St. Julian of Norwich in Austin, Texas, who facilitated our work on Saturday. Here are some of my takeaways from these events, and I encourage you to listen as I read them slowly. Real change can occur when people have a sense of being in relationship, have a sense of being heard, have a sense of dreaming together in community, have a sense of choosing to contribute, have a sense of acting supportively, and have a sense of being positive. In light of those reflections, what's your experience in your particular faith community and congregation? What sorts of opportunities or things that need to change so that you can really live into more positively the kind of change you're looking for? From the Invite, Welcome, and Connect workshop, I walked away with so much information, but I want to share three challenging pieces of information that just sort of made me sit up and listen. First, 98% of the people who will visit your faith community or your congregation will have looked at your website first. Will have looked at your website first before they come and see you. Second, 3 out of 4 people have said that they would be willing to come to church if they were personally invited. Third, and this is the most astounding one, on average, an Episcopalian invites someone to church every 37 years. Is that your experience? When's the last time you invited someone to church? I have a friend who said, "Doug, if you don't have friends that you can invite to church, you need to make some new friends." So, who are the friends in your community, in your context, that you might consider inviting to become part of the faith community that you so treasure and value? Our challenges and opportunities are clear, so let's begin to focus our energies and resources on evangelism, inviting, welcoming, and encouraging people to connect to our faith communities wherever they may be, and taking the steps that are necessary to make this come into a reality for all of us in the Episcopal Church in Northern Indiana. Mark of Mission 2 is to teach, baptize, and nurture new believers. The ongoing formation of our youth and children falls under this particular Mark of Mission, and I want to encourage every single one of us to invite the children and youth in our faith communities to come to our kids' camp this June. The theme is Tree of Life, hanging out on the Episcopal branch of the Jesus Movement. Bishop Curry, his theme, and now our theme. The dates are Sunday, June 11th through Saturday, June 17th. You can register on the diocesan website under the Events tab. I also want to invite our senior high youth to consider participating in our Mission Week, which begins on Sunday, the 25th of June, and concludes on Saturday, the 1st of July. They will be working with the faith communities of the Calumet Episcopal Ministry Partnership, which is on the west side of our diocese. As I conclude this reflection with you, I want to share a prayer that was authored by the people at St. Albans in Fort Wayne. It's specifically a prayer that they've been using, but it applies, I think, to all of us as we look at our Mark 1 mission initiatives. Let us pray. O God, who has brought us into the fellowship of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, lead the family of St. Albans and all the faith communities in our diocese, day by day, ever closer to thee and to one another, and grant that our common life and work in sacrificial service may help to build up thy kingdom, both at St. Albans and where all we are, and in all the world. Help us to open, invite, welcome, and connect others, and to inspire our witness to Jesus, that all may know the power of forgiveness and the hope of his resurrection. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.